My name is Massey Campos, and I'm the president and the national director for the American Club Outreach here at Institute on the Constitution. Many of you know me, my family, and the call that God has placed in my life as a minister of His gospel. But for those of you who don't know me, please allow me a moment to introduce myself. First of all, I'm a Christian and an ordained minister of the saving grace of Jesus Christ. I am of Hispanic descent, and both of my parents are from San Luis Potosí and Nuevo León, Mexico, and are pastors of a small church in Mathis, Texas. Being raised in a Christian home was the norm, but I hadn't yet known Christ for myself. Then in 2001, I met Jake McCauley, who is the current CEO of IOTC, and he led me to Christ, and my life was radically changed. We have then since been in ministry together, fighting in many of America's proverbial trenches for the Judeo-Christian principles found in our U.S. Constitution. In 2004, I met Michael Perutka, then presidential candidate and founder of Institute on the Constitution. I went on to graduate from the course. My faith was increased, and now I was convinced of my civil duties, and I went to work. In September of 2014, Michael, Jake, and I decided to work together to reach the youth of this nation with the foundational and divine truths that are found in our founding documents. Being Hispanic, I see the need to reach citizens of many backgrounds with the lawful and American view of the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, and the Bill of Rights. I am living proof that the Constitution and the Institute on the Constitution are multicultural, but singular in our values of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
We see a lot of nasty progression out there right now with the Ferguson riots and things like that, and we have to keep our heads on right as Christians, not to be vengeful and not to be angry, but to be compassionate and loving, but also show them what law is and where law comes from. And most people don't even realize that law is from our Creator. God ordains law. Man does not give law. Man does not ordain what you should do with your life. God does. And that's the way our founders wanted it. And we've been doing these American clubs, these high school outreach programs, let me share with you for a minute, since last October. What we're doing in the schools is we preach the American view of law and government, which is there's three facets. Number one, there is a God. We can all acknowledge that. Our Declaration says that we are endowed with certain inalienable rights from our Creator, who created us equal, correct? Second is our rights come from Him. Obviously, man doesn't ordain law. If that was the case, Hitler would have been right, but he wasn't, because he disobeyed God's law, which is thou shalt not murder. And he was lying and manipulating. So obviously God ordains law, not man. And third is the purpose of government is to secure your rights. In other words, not take away your rights. One of the most attacked people in this country is Christians, you know, not any other religion. And the moment we say something is sin, they call it racism or they call it bigotry, which is not the case. Sin is universal. When people sin, it is from their hearts. It's not because of their skin color or because of their gender. So we are establishing this with kids and giving them a proper understanding and a balance of their founders, the biblical heritage of our documents, and our Constitution, and why government was created in the first place.
I asked the kids, do you think we're born equal? They said, yeah, we're born equal, because that's what they're taught today. Thomas Jefferson told Benjamin Franklin, each word, Dr. Franklin, was specifically chosen for a purpose in this declaration. Look what he says, all men are created equal. Where does he say life begins? Why are we debating abortion in the first place in this country?
That's right.
It's right here. Your documents say, your state constitution acknowledges Almighty God. We're going to get into that too, okay? It says that they are endowed by their Creator. There is a God with certain inalienable rights. Our rights come from Him, right? And among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I go into a little discussion about the pursuit of happiness and what that meant. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men. So what is the purpose of government? Is only to secure my rights. That's all their function is. All men have a natural and indefeasible right to worship Almighty God according to the dictates of their own consciences. According to what God tells me to do is how I see fit. That's what God has ordained me to do. That's why there's different denominations. It says, no man shall be compelled to attend, erect, or support any place of worship, or to maintain a ministry agent against his consent. No human authority ought in any case or whatever to control or interfere with the rights of conscience in the matters of religion. What did he just say? What did that just say? No human authority can interfere with how you worship God. I ask kids a lot, are we a democracy or a republic? What do you think the common answer is? Democracy, because you know what? Still, even our Republican presidential candidates today still say we're a democracy. They're wrong. We were founded as a constitutional republic that are democratically elected officials to uphold constitutional law. Do you guys know what a patriot is? And 1828 is defined as an upholder of dying laws. Right? And if you guys do that, you are a patriot in my book, friends. And you Christians are my brothers. And I'm my brother's keeper. And I'm going to watch out for the church because God watched out for me.